How do you get one look to follow another look automatically? Well, in Blackout, you can do that with a click of a button. Let's take a look. Okay, so I have these three looks. Let's say when I press go, I want them to go to full, wait a second, and then fade out. And I only want to hit the button once. How do we do this? Well, like with all the sidebar options, if I double tap looks, I get my looks expanded view. And what I want to do is link our outlook to the full look. And that's what this box right here does. Okay. Now, if I check that, it's going to go straight there because there's no timing involved. And we can see that because there are zeros in all of these fields. For you guys, it might say three. It's whatever your default timing is in Blackout settings. You can find that by going to the Blackout logo, going to settings, and looking at default look transition time. Mine is zero, so that's why there are zeros. So what I really want is a delay and then a fade out on just my outlook. Because when I hit go, I want to go to the full look and then delay before it goes to the outlook. So I'll make the delay 1 second here. And I want my fade down to be, I don't know, 2 seconds. Okay, we can close out of this. So now when I hit go, it goes to the full look and then waits a second and fades out. Okay, I'll play that again. So I'm in look one, they go to full, it waits a second and then fades out. And that's how you link looks. Let me show one more example that I use all the time, and that's with hazers. When I'm running hazers that don't have fine controls over DMX, you're just turning them on and then turning them off, I find to get the ratio right, I like to haze for like 1 minute and then have them off for around 45 seconds. This ratio can change. Sometimes it's half and half depending on how hazy we like it. I just find this makes it a lot easier to get a nice level. It's just a pro tip. You should try it yourself. I bet you'll like it. So I'll grab just my hazer here and I'll set it to full. Because when I start this sequence, I usually want the hazer to turn on right away so we know it's working. So I'll make a new sequence here by hitting record. And I'll change the sequence number to 2. And I'll call this Hazer On. And I'll select selection only because I only want the hazer in and I just need the intensity there, so manual values only. I'm in my main sequence, so I want to go to the sequence I just made. So I'll select sequence 2 here. And now I want the hazer to turn off. So I'll just hit out here and record that as a second look. And I'll call this Hazer Off. And save that. Now it's the same thing. How did we find the look timing? You double tap looks. So I'll double tap looks. And now I just want this to loop, right? So I'm actually gonna hit the checkbox on both looks. So right now with both looks linked, it's not gonna really do anything because there's no timing. So Blackout's just gonna do this back and forth between the two looks instantly. So we need to add delays. So here, the delay for the on cue is actually how long it's going to spend off. And the delay for the off cue is how long it spends on. It makes sense if you think about it, but honestly, just play through the cue with quick timings and you'll understand what's going on. So let's take a look. So let's say we have a really powerful hazer, so I only want to haze for 2 seconds. And I want it to be off for 5 seconds. Again, these aren't real numbers. In real life, I find 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 45, 1 minute, stuff like that. So now let's close out and see what happens. If we play the look, you can see that the hazer is off, and then it hazes for 2 seconds, and then it turns off for 5 seconds. So these were two little examples to show you how you can get looks to automatically follow each other in sequences. Hopefully this was helpful. If you want to go a step further, check out my video on individual fixture timing within looks, and let me know in the comments what you want to see more of. I'll see you next time.